Bacteria lives everywhere. In the sky, on the earth, in the oceans, and in your beard. Sup guys, Trace here for DNews, and I'm gonna shampoo the crap out of my face after this one. Recently, the Daily Mail Online reported an interview with a trichologist from the Birmingham Trichology Center, and she said facial hair is coarser than other hair, so it traps dirt and germs more easily. So we wanted to know, on behalf of my bearded brethren, are beards gross and germy? Is this a thing? Human skin is covered in microbes, including bacteria, archaea, fungi, viruses, and mites, constantly. It's always there. Don't reach for the antibacterial whatever. Most of it is either good for you or harmless. In fact, a study in Nature looking at the diversity of bacteria on our skin found different parts of the skin have different species of bacteria. For example, the bottom of the heel alone has 80 different species of bacteria living there. Most of the skin is considered a harsh environment for bacteria, but in folds of skin, darker, wetter areas like underarms, or oily spots like behind the ear, bacteria thrive. So mom was right, clean behind your ears. According to skin pharmacology and physiology, 25% of our bacterial population live in hair follicles. Again, this is completely normal and can be beneficial. Other studies have shown washing your face won't even clear out all the bacteria. In fact, in the 1960s, a US Army microbiologist researcher looked into the ability of beard hair to hold bacteria and transmit it to other people. Researchers sprayed beards with non-infectious bacteria and allowed them to rest in the hair for a while, then they washed their beards. After cleaning, there was still enough bacteria to spread to other people. This experiment has been repeated a number of times over the years with similar results, and mustaches, they aren't safe either. In fact, according to a specialist from Queen's University in Canada, mustaches are hotbeds for bacteria because of the moist air leaving the body through the nose and mouth. Thus, it creates even more bacteria. I knew mustaches were gross. I knew it. I should have trusted my instinct. After a study published in the journal Microbiology and Immunity repeated the experiment yet again, they claimed that we should find a way to decontaminate human hair. So, I'm sorry to say, friends, beards are filled with bacteria. But just in case this hasn't become clear yet, it's not just beards. Scientists from the University of Arizona tested the hairbrushes of 30 different women and found 20% more bacteria living on the brush than was living on the bathroom sink or even a dog bowl. The brushes contain dead skin, oil, and obviously hair, which is a breeding ground for bacteria. Okay, I'll stop fear-mongering. Remember, the flora which live in and on our bodies isn't gonna harm us. It's symbiotic, for the most part. It feeds on our oils and dead skin cells. The bacteria living in your beard is the same bacteria that lives on your skin all the time. It's always there. Shaving won't rid you of this evil beard bacteria. If for some reason you are worried though, all bacteria can be managed by regular hygiene. Shampoo or soap your hair to cut oil and thus bacterial load. Also, just a general, non-gross rule, make sure there is no food caught in your beard because that's weird and gross. Sure, humans are gross and icky and whatever, but we have been this way for millions of years. So why should we start worrying about it now? But what do you guys think about all this? You can tell us down in the comments. And if you're questioning your facial hair now, you should watch my video about how we have reached peak beard. Beards are so over. Check it out right down there. And thank you for watching DNews.